There's so much to do in Cleveland every summer. Let me give you 20 ideas that won't disappoint you. Let's start on the shores of Lake Erie with EDGEWATER Beach. This park has something for everyone, whether you want to get a drink and watch the sunset from the beach house, get a group together for volleyball, or let the kids build a sandcastle. It's so great to spend an afternoon or an evening here. You can rent kayaks and other beach gear from the little hut. This is the place to be. Let's talk about kayaking on the Cuyahoga River. Yes, that river. Great Lakes Watersports in the flats rent single and double kayaks. We're talking 25 or 30 bucks an hour to explore the river at your own pace. You can get some really unique views of the city. This is a great way to explore and get some exercise. If you'd like an easier way to enjoy the river, then there's a waterfront restaurants in the flats east bank. Alley Cat Oyster Bar is really good. Collision Bend Brewing Company has a huge patio right on the river where you can park your boat. Lindey's Lake House, another great patio with yard games, and the rooftop bar at Punch Bowl Social, bowling and mini golf downstairs. Wait till you see the Canopy Walk and Emergent Tower at the Holden Arboretum. There's a huge walkway 65 feet above the forest floor that gets you right into the canopy of the trees. And their biggest addition has got to be the Emergent Tower. It's a stairway that takes you so high you're above all the trees, 120 feet off the ground. Stargazing at Observatory Park. This is the NASA Astronomical Station in the Geauga Park District, and their research-grade telescope is the size of a rocket. It's part of Observatory Park, which is a certified dark sky park. You've got to come here on a night when they open their telescopes for public viewing. There's all kinds of astronomy nights and a planetarium in case the sky is too cloudy. Imagine sitting out on the lawn with a picnic basket and a bottle of wine, getting to hear one of the best orchestras in the world. I'd recommend going on a night when they show a movie and the orchestra plays the soundtrack live. Whether it's at Blossom Music Center or Severance Hall, the Cleveland Orchestra is world class. Heinen's downtown is inside an old school bank rotunda that's been repurposed into Cleveland's premier grocery store. From the wine machines to the kombucha on tap, it's a great place to get lunch, whether you eat inside or outside. I totally recommend you stop in and check it out. Bar 32 has the best view of any rooftop bar in the city. It's on the 32nd floor of the Hilton Downtown Hotel. You can eat outside with views of Lake Erie and the entire city. There's a really cool side room that's a little more private. And if you'd like a drink recommendation, the view and the Aperol Tini are some of their best. Yes, there's a national park in Cleveland's backyard. Cuyahoga Valley National Park is 33,000 acres. You can't go wrong by taking a hike on the Ledges Trail. This is some of the most scenic hiking in Ohio. There's over 100 miles of hiking trail inside the park. Some of them include waterfalls like Brandywine Falls. It's beautiful. But really the best thing is to explore the park by bike. The Ohio and Erie Canal Towpath Trail runs for 20 miles through the park. You can rent a bike in Bedford or Peninsula. A good tip I'll share is to ride your bike one way and then take the Cuyahoga Valley Scenic Railroad back to where you started for $5. The Cleveland Metro Park Zoo is one of the most visited attractions in Northeast Ohio every year. Make sure to see Asian Highlands and Tiger Passage. There are hundreds of species of animals here, and the zoo consistently builds new exhibits. There's something about the indoor rainforest exhibit that's always been fascinating. I think people of all ages will be thrilled with a visit to the zoo. North Coast Harbor is on Cleveland's lakefront, and there's so much here. You can go deep into the belly of an actual submarine on the USS Cod and see everything from the control room to the kitchen. The steamship William G. Mather is a retired Great Lakes freighter that lets you tour every square inch. If you want to actually cruise Lake Erie, there's the Good Time 3. The Great Lakes Science Center is a major attraction which includes a NASA Glenn Visitor Center and an actual Apollo Command Module. Nuevo is a Mexican restaurant with great patios and sand volleyball courts behind it. The International Women's Air and Space Museum has exhibits on Amelia Earhart, Bessie Coleman, the women of NASA, and lots more. And if that's not enough, there's the most visited museum in Ohio, the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. The Cleveland Botanical Garden is one of a kind. All throughout the summer, you'll see a huge variety of blooms with fun themes like the waterfall garden, the rain garden, the butterfly garden. There's a great kids' garden with mazes and little hobbit houses to run around, tree houses too. And rain or shine, you have to see the glasshouse biomes, a Costa Rican cloud forest with two levels, and the spiny desert of Madagascar with its chameleons and tortoises. Nothing says Cleveland quite like the Terminal Tower. There's an observation deck on the 42nd floor that's open on the weekends. You won't get a better view of the city that's open to the public. When this tower was built, it was the tallest building in the world outside of New York City. This is a can't-miss attraction. East 4th Street is very popular for Cleveland visitors. There are over a dozen restaurants and bars right next to each other in this alleyway. The Greenhouse Tavern is a great option for summer with two outdoor patios. One of them is on the roof. Jonathan Sawyer, the chef, is a James Beard Award winner. There's a lot here. League Park is the place where the Indians won the 1920 World Series and later where Babe Ruth hit his 500th home run. The city has preserved the field and even built a fence to match the huge right field wall that used to be here. You should come and see the Baseball Heritage Museum. They actually have a Babe Ruth home run ball signed by Babe Ruth, Willie Mays, and other legends. If you love baseball, this needs to be on your list. That brings us to the Indians' modern-day home at Progressive Field, one of the best places to watch a ball game in all of baseball. A lot of local Cleveland restaurants have set up shop inside the park. Don't forget Sweet Moses for your ice cream sundae. Lakeview Cemetery is the burial place of John D. Rockefeller and other famous Clevelanders, and the most beautiful memorial is for President James Garfield. The balcony outside has a fantastic view of the city and the lake. Another spot you can't miss is Wade Chapel. The entire interior was designed by Lewis Comfort Tiffany in his studio. Thousands of pieces of stained glass. There's symbolism everywhere you look. This is one of Cleveland's hidden gems. I'm so glad that our area is home to all kinds of adaptive recreation for people of all abilities. This is Herb, and he's playing at the Turn Golf Course where the carts allow him to be upright and swing the club. Valley Riding has therapeutic horseback riding for people of all abilities. The Cleveland Metro Parks has hand cycles, and they're adding new adaptive options every year. And Three Trackers is an incredible organization. A big favorite is adaptive paddling and kayaking. They even do water skiing. I can't cover all the ice cream options in Cleveland, but I can tell you a few. If you're looking for where the locals go, Honey Hut makes all of their ice cream sweetened with honey. If you're looking for a spot with an old school feel, East Coast Custard in Parma Heights opened in the 80s, and their frozen custard is a throwback to the early 1900s. And last but not least, the Solstice Steps at Lakewood Park. Watching the sunset here is an event. If you get a good one, people erupt in applause when the sun disappears below the Lake Erie horizon. I hope this gives you some ideas to get excited about whether you're visiting Cleveland or have lived here your whole life. If you like this video, please share it with a friend so we can make more of them. Check out these playlists for more Exploring Cleveland videos.